These are the most expensive fragrances from Temu. Despite being criticized for their shady business practices, Temu was one of the only places you can shop like a millionaire without actually being, well, a millionaire. And that's exactly what I did. Temu sells almost anything you can think of, including these knockoff fragrances. But the real question on Temu is, does price equal quality? That's why I bought the most expensive fragrances they had to offer, and we're about to find out. Come to me! These 10 fragrances cost me $222, so we might be in for a treat. I'm gonna start with this one. First up, we have Sacco Old Wood. Likely a clone of Tom Ford's Oud Wood. The bottle and presentation on this reminds me of those Miu Miu fragrances back in the day. I think they were Miu Miu, they're little colorful ones. Temu back then? I don't know, you living. And this is a good one. All right, so I was right. This one does smell very similar, at least on the onset, to Tom Ford's Oud Wood. To me, Sacco Oud Wood is sensual, it's inviting. Overall, this is a nice fragrance. It doesn't come off as off-putting. It's not as potent as you would get in Tom Ford's Oud Wood, but this is a nice fragrance nonetheless. I paid $23 for this fragrance, and if it projects and lasts like it does right now, I would say you're in for a treat. Next, we have Profundo Nero Limited Edition. Now, the name of this one might make you think this one comes from the Acqua di Gio line, but the presentation, at least the box, looks very Prada-esque. As I was picking this fragrance up, I was originally thinking about Prada Luna Rosa Extreme. The presentation from the pictures look extremely similar. That fragrance has been discontinued and is super hard to find. So if you could get one for a fraction of the price, then maybe, just maybe, Temu's the way to go. But only time will tell. Now, the presentation, as you can see, does say black, very similar to Prada Luna Rosa Extreme, so we'll give this one a shot. Hopefully it's like a clone. Nope, not it. Not it. When I think of Prada Luna Rosa Extreme, that fragrance is phenomenal. In fact, it's one of the best from the entire lineup, in my personal opinion. Now, it's not that this fragrance is bad, it's that it's not great. And I would say this probably lends more to the Acqua di Gio series of fragrances, although it doesn't smell like those either. When I think of Prada Luna Rosa Extreme, that one's a little darker. That's one that I would wear often on rainy days, and this one is probably one I would wear on a spring day. It's clean, it's fairly inoffensive, and this one almost comes off as like a shower gel or body scrub. At the whopping price of $13, I'm gonna say it's okay. This next fragrance was just over $14, $14.39 to be exact, and this one reminded me of one of my favorite fragrances in high school, which happened to be Givenchy Pie, you know, 3.14. I see what they did here. Listen, the price on this fragrance happened to be $14.39. You mix those around, you got pie. As you can see, the box was damaged, which led the fragrance to be broken. And if the fragrance bottle on the presentation is any indication of what we're going to experience with this fragrance, then we're probably going to pass. Now, as I mentioned, Givenchy Pie was one of my favorite fragrances in high school, but it was a little older than need be, but it did have a sophisticated, sensual flair to it. Let's see if we get it in Gemini. This one reminds me of dried paint in a can. It lacks everything that Givenchy Pie was standing for. It's not sensual, it's not mysterious. It doesn't have that powdery feel to it. There's nothing about this fragrance here that excites me. Keep your $14.39 in your pocket and pass on this one. Now, this next fragrance was supposed to be a long-lasting woody fragrance, but we'll see if it lives up to it. For a whopping $15, this fragrance is called Make a New Tomorrow Perfume. To me, that means this fragrance is not going to last you through the day, because they're going to make a new one tomorrow and run off with your money. On the back of the box here, it says it features bergamot, cardamom, iris, jasmine, cedar, and rock orchid. Now, I would say that's probably a win because none of the other fragrances that we've had so far had any notes on them. So maybe we're on to something. Now, from the presentation, you might think that this one is related to Frederick Mall, but no, my friend, this is the Memphis edition because it is FNF. Shout out to Glorilla. 1, 2, 3. This one comes off extremely medicinal. It smells like chloroceptic. Is that what it's called when you spray it in your mouth? Like, now I'm not sure who would want to walk around smelling like this. Maybe because some people are into fragrances that have more of an artistic appeal to them. But this one, my friend, is not it. Now, as this fragrance further develops, I am getting a little hint of cedar within this fragrance, or some type of woody note. Let's revisit the box and see what this one is about. Okay, so there is cedar in the base here. I'm getting a bit of that. It does start off kind of medicinal. In fact, very medicinal. Is it one that I would recommend? No, and it's also disappearing. Like we thought, they're running away with your money. This one's a pass. I know what some of you are thinking. Yo, B, didn't you learn your lesson the first go around? No, I didn't. That's why we are back. But to make sure that you don't fall into a trap like this, be sure to check out my friends over at maxaroma.com. Click on the link down below and you'll get to experience offerings, savings, and discounts like none other because you are watching the channel. Browse to their website and experience thousands of new fragrances or revisit a fragrance that you love from yesteryear. No matter which one you choose to do, just know that Max Aroma is there for you. Next, we have a fragrance called No Time, which to me means in no time, you're gonna fall in love. This fragrance cost me 20 smackaroos. We'll see if this fragrance is worth it. Now, the presentation on itself almost lends this to this Tom Ford type of feel, but it's in a much bigger presentation, so you will be getting that Mac Daddy. Also, it clearly notes that this one is an eau de parfum, so we are expecting a stronger, more potent fragrance. There are a bunch of QR codes on here. I'm gonna choose not to scan it. QR codes in themselves can be tricky. Don't be scanning everything all willy-nilly. Listen, I just made a discovery. On the top of this bottle, it says Majesty's Secret Pharaoh Max. Are there pheromones in this fragrance? I'm not sure. I gotta look it up. It doesn't say if there has pheromones, but what it does say is that this is from Ouchy Secret Agent. Maybe my nose is in for a burning. Who names their shop Ouchy Secret Agent? It's not even spelled right. This is good. I like this. Okay, I take it back. I take it back. This is not a bad fragrance. It's very clean. Another fragrance that smells fresh out of the shower. I would be comfortable wearing this so far casually. I could rock this one to the office if I wanted to. And I don't think anyone would know none the wiser. Now, based on what I've learned from Temu fragrances in the past, you probably need to bring this with you because it's not going to project a ton. It's not going to last forever either. But currently at the $20 price point, I feel like this one will be on par with something that you will find at TJ Maxx and or Burlington. Otherwise, I think you're good. At $20, this one could be a win. Now that one was so nice that we gotta do it twice. We're gonna run back with this other fragrance we picked up from them. And this one's called Blue Sky. Hopefully they don't let me down. Now Blue Sky just happened to be a bit more expensive. And this one was $26, a full $6 ahead of the prior fragrance that we talked about. So maybe it'll be like a third better. Now Blue Sky does have a bluish presentation as you might expect, but it almost reminds me of YSL. Why? Let's see if the fragrance is any close. This one does not smell like YSLY, but it does have this interesting thing going on. There's almost this mint note in the back. Think of double mint gum. In that case, it would be spearmint. I'm challenging the missus to try Blue Sky. She likes it. She likes it, fellas. She really likes it. I could see myself wearing this. In fact, I would hate one of you guys to go out here and buy it and not like it. But I would pay like 60 bucks for this fragrance if I saw it in the store. I'd be like, yeah, I will buy this one. This one's legit. So listen, the quality on these fragrances are better than we've seen in the past with some of the others. Who says you don't get what you pay for? Not I. This is good. We keep smelling it. Another one that's fresh. This one's also youthful in my opinion. And not that it's a young fragrance, but I feel like that it has a nice youthful feel to it, that you would feel like lively and energetic by wearing this fragrance, and it's likely from that mint note that's here. Along with that mint, I'm also getting some type of lemon within this one. It's not a bad buy in my opinion. Again, very early on, only first impressions. Not sure how this one will last, but for 26 bucks, I would say it's legit. We're on a roll with these fragrances, so why not go for the three-peat? This one is called Silver Vetiver, also an Eau de Parfum, and from the same brand as the last two fragrances. So we'll see if this one is good, and will we go 3 for 3? Now, if I had to judge, which I will, the presentation on Silver Vetiver is not as good as the other two, in my personal opinion. This metallic-y feel or mirrored feel on the bottle gives it a cheaper look, in my opinion, although it's just like the others. All right, are you gonna catch up or what, buddy? Come on, come on. I think we got a dud. I did not know it was gonna do that. All right, I'll tell you what I'm getting from the little spritz of fragrance that we've gotten here. It's not bad. In fact, you could tell that there's vetiver in this fragrance, but it's also some type of bergamot or a lemon here. Doesn't smell super dirty or earthy. I would liken this one more towards like a Tom Ford's Grey Vetiver. Obviously nowhere near it, but along those lines. The missus just said that this one is giving her a headache, which is weird because it didn't spray as much, but I did spray it a bunch to see what I could get out. But I was going to say that out of the three, I'm digging this one the most. This one has this professional feel to it. And if some of you are starting off in the corporate world and just need something to get you by, again, proceed with caution. It might not last long and you might have to spray a million sprays like I did, but I don't think this is a bad scent. But let's carry on. This next one is called Safari Men. Is it wild? Is it untamed? Will it row? Help you get them, tiger? We'll see. Of the fragrances we're talking about today, this one is the most expensive, coming in at a whopping $27. The presentation on this fragrance leaves me underwhelmed. Now, it does say Safari Men written there on this black leather, and then a bunch of safaris embossed here, but I think this one's gonna be trash. Well, it did spray right out of the gate. Maybe I'm wrong. This one is like mouthwash. It's like a bubblegum mouthwash, but it's a mouthwash that you would use and you know it's not gonna make your breath fresh. Yeah, this is not it. It's cooling. I guess it could be calming, but I wouldn't tell any of you to spend $27 on this fragrance. Not worth it, hard pass. Next we have Explore Pour Homme, and hopefully this one's like Explorer. Now, even if it's like Explorer from the House of Mont Blanc, I'm not gonna tell you to spend it because you're better off just buying Mont Blanc Explorer. But we'll see. The presentation on this one does look like it's going to be different, as it is blue versus that black, which leads me to believe that this one is going to be like an aquatic fragrance, if colors could tell you everything. Boom, okay. Now this is different. Based on the presentation of this, this top piece here reminds me of Bulgari fragrances. Think back to like Bulgari Black. Oh my goodness, it feels super cheap. It's making creaking noises. It's like the Tin Man. He needed oil for his body when he was up to see the wizard. Yeah. It's not it, fellas. $26.48. So let's say this one's $27 as well. Let's round the other one up to 28, because that was technically $26.48. I do not recommend. 0 out of 10. Listen, when you think about fragrances, especially at this price point, it's everything included. Presentation, way this fragrance smells. This one has a strong alcohol feel in the top. It does dissipate quickly and turn into something more pleasant, but for the $27, you're better off just buying one of these other ones that we talked about or an official fragrance from our friends over at Max Aroma. And you might not be able to get full bottles of your favorites, but you could definitely get pocket perfumes to carry around. Now, I want to be fair here. This isn't the worst fragrance that I've ever smelled, but it's definitely not the best. And at the $27 price point, I know that we can find better. although there were some others that I would recommend. This is not it. I don't want this one for you, so avoid it like the plague if you can. Next, we have the One Ohm, and this one looks more like a Mont Blanc presentation than the last fragrance, but we'll see if this one smells anything like Mont Blanc. The One Ohm. Let's see if we can make it ASMR. Ta-da! Not bad. I could smell it in the air, like Beanie Siegel. This is pleasant, masculine. That's all I gotta say about it. But all jokes aside, this one does come off as fresh, pleasant, slightly fruity, but well-versed in the Temu back then. Presentation of this fragrance isn't bad, so it could sit well on a shelf. And when I purchased this fragrance, it was 17 bucks. Now, for all of the fragrances that we talked about today, you could probably find better alternatives out there. And at the very least, you could do a pocket perfume of a brand that you really love to carry around. Now, this one's 17 bucks. You get a full-size bottle. Full fragrance, it's not bad. It's not great. It's pretty generic all around, which isn't necessarily a bad thing. It's just that you won't stand out in a crowd. I would also say the One Ohm is a little darker than some of the fragrances that we've discussed so far. But if you had 17 bucks to spend and you wanted to try it out, then by all means, go for it. So there you have it. Here's how I spent $222 at Temu on their most expensive fragrances, at least at the time of purchasing, which is back in December. What I will say is that these fragrances do smell better than the original fragrances that we picked up, which might mean on Temu, price does equal quality. If you missed the first video where we purchased cheap fragrances from Temu, then click here. It's one you don't want to miss.